Hey guys, so it's another get ready with me video. People seem to like these and enjoy these, so it's not too hard just to record myself getting ready before I record another video, so I will do that. And today I have four lipstick options that I've been kind of mulling about in my head, so I don't know where this will end up, but I was thinking either Watch Me Simmer from MAC, Real Sexy from MAC, I think it's called Blase Apricot from Revlon, which is one of their Moon Drops lipsticks, or NARS, oh shit, how do I pronounce this? Skiop? Skiop? Yeah. S-C-I-H-A-P. I think it's Skiop. 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 I think it's Skiop. Skiop. I think it's like Skiop. Because when I was in New York and I was at the Met and I went to that like, conversation with Prada exhibit, in part of the conversation that the two women were having, I forget the name of the other one, they said that word, and I think it was like Skiop, and I like wrote it down in my phone, like, that is how you pronounce this. Yeah, so, okay, so this is just another one of those videos. Let's get started. I will be using my Dr. Jart BB cream because I'm really feeling this shit lately, so why not use it? I just take about that much, in case any of you are curious about how much I actually use. A very small amount, and it goes a long way. Alrighty then. Next up, concealing. I will be using the Makeup Forever Full Cover Concealer, because I think I like this more than the Makeup Forever HD Concealer, which I was using. So I think I'll use this up, and I might never repurchase this again. I think because I have a lot of freckles under here, if I have something that's too thin, it ends up just looking a little strange because my freckles see through, so it just looks like it's just a poor match or whatever. So this is just, you know, full cover, look at the name, and so I think it just is a little bit better of blocking out the freckles. Not that I want to cover up my freckles, because I do really like them, but I think it just looks better in person up close than that one does. So, that's all. Next, Bobbi Brown Creamy Concealer and Real Techniques Deluxe Crease Brush. Check! All done with that. Next step, powder your face. I will be using, as always, MAC Studio Fix Powder NW15, MAC 187. Done with these. The next step is, I guess, let's put on some blush, what do you say? And I'm gonna be doing the same kind of blush routine I've been doing in the past couple of them because I just love Candid Coral. And if I'm gonna do a lipstick look, this is just an amazing blush to have because it just makes your face look nice and it doesn't overpower your look. It doesn't make, it doesn't look matchy-matchy with your lips or anything like that. It's just, it's honestly just perfect. So, can't get enough of that. I think someone in my comments, I think it was like the first Get Ready With Me video or something, and someone said like, I think you would look better if you put your blush like higher on your cheek or something like that. So I took that to mean like, oh, put it like right around here. And I've been doing that, and honestly, I think it looks like so much better, so good. So if that was what that person had intended and what that person had meant, thank you so much, because I really like wearing my blush just like really high up on my cheekbones, like right here, instead of, you know, getting it all the way down here on the apples. I don't know. I don't think it just doesn't look that good on me. This just really, I think, looks amazing. So, commenter, I love you. Woohoo! That was my Vicky Gumbelson impression from Real Housewives of Orange County. I can't do it as good as her. Woohoo! I don't know. Too early in the morning for that. Okay, next up, Dior Amber Diamond. I'm sorry that I keep using this because it's so expensive, but it's pretty. And I'm a magpie. Ooh, probably should have put Painterly Paint Pot on first if I'm gonna be bringing that up there. Ooh. Whatever. I don't play by rules because I'm a no-nonsense gal. Whoa. Okay, Painterly Paint Pot. Okay. Eyebrow time. I love putting on my eyebrows. It really is just the favorite part of my routine because I'm just like, oh, I'm a different person. I love it. Oh yeah, eyebrow power. I just love wearing eyebrows. Makes my face, okay, this is a thing about Philadelphia, and I know it's a thing about like a lot of places, but women of Philadelphia, lay down your tweezers. Embrace a fuller brow, embrace a filled-in brow, embrace a tinted brow. But brows are meant to be on your face, so do not make them, you know, a tiny, tiny little line. Because it's not cute, it just looks scary. My biggest thing for every single, like, woman, man, and child in the world, if you want to improve your appearance, straight out, fill in your brows, and let them be full. No joke. I wish I was born with, like, gigantic eyebrows so I could even have them bigger than this. But I basically wish, what is it? It's like Persian or Armenian people just have, like, amazing big brows. I wish I was Persian or Armenian. They're so gorgeous. So, and I also wish I was black. Why can't we change our skin color like we can change our clothes? So Michael Jackson, I totally understand what you're going through, man. Some days I would want to be black, some days I'd want to be Asian, some days I'd want to be Persian, some days I want to be Armenian, some days I'd want to be Mexican, some days, I don't know. It's all so beautiful, I just want to try it on. You know what I mean? Like, I'm one color always, rawr. Chelsea smash. It's just not fair. So this is like a development that I'm hoping that happens future, like late, like in the future, is that you can be different ethnicities on different days. It's like wearing a wig, but it's like a skin wig, if you know what I'm talking about. Those are my hopes and dreams. Someday, someday. Okay. Now it is time to move on to the eyes, and once again, no fucking clue what I'm doing here. Just kind of winging it. So, let's go for something not brown, because we've been doing brown for a while. Oops, didn't wash my brush. So I'll just kind of, try to get the excess brown out of there before we do anything. And why don't I just... I'm going to apply... What is this little thing? I depotted a palette, okay. Skimp. Okay, I'm going to apply Urban Decay's Skimp all over my lid. Now I'm going to take Max Quarry and kind of use that as a crease color, but not really. I don't know. I'm just gonna put it on there. Okay, and then with my finger, I'm going to take Max Vanilla and put that on my brow bone. And in my inner corners, I'm going to take some of Floof by MAC. Don't forget the exclamation point. I'm gonna take Floof! I think that's how you're supposed to say it, since there's an exclamation point. And I'm also gonna run that along the bottom lash line using 209. And then last up, I'm gonna take a little bit of this jumbo eye pencil in Milk from NYX and just do the tiniest little bit on the inner corner as well. Oh shit! You guys, I don't know my own strength. I just broke this. I just stuck this on and slammed the top in, and now, oh, crackers! I can't get the top off. And I smushed the lid. Be gentle with your products, you guys. They have feelings too. Okie dokies. I'm also going to take Eyebeam double-ended brightener from Smashbox and apply this to my lower waterline. To give myself that I wasn't drinking a shit ton of wine last night look. Oh, I need to sharpen that. That scratched me. Okay, what is left? What is left? What is left? Mascara! My trusty friend. My BFF forever. Revlon Girlicious Mascara. What a difference some mascara makes. It is just so beautiful. I could kiss myself. I don't think you guys want to watch that. Actually, some little weirdos might. Gotta check and see how many 45-year-old men are watching these videos, and then I'll know my answer. Okay, so we are at the end of the line, the moment of truth. Lipstick, what lipstick to choose, you know? Got the four right here. I wish this was like a live thing so I could be like, vote! No, no one cares enough about what I wear on my lips to vote about it. Go vote in the election, don't vote on this. Let's go with Real Sexy, because I am feeling real sexy. And not R-E-A-L, I'm feeling R-E-E-L sexy. That's how, you know, movie Real Sexy. So this is an awesome color. This is an Amplified. It was from the Real Sexy collection. I only know that because it's the exact same name as the collection. I'm pretty awful at remembering collection names. No, I remember Très, Cheek, and Real Sexy. That's it. Hello Sailor, that was one, right? I didn't get anything from that. Okay, forgot to do anything to my lips. Forgot to put a lip balm down. Hopefully this still looks good. It's an Amplified. That's usually a pretty fuss-free finish, so let's go. Okay guys, so I did it. I bit the bullet. I picked a lipstick. I picked Real Sexy. It's a little bright, but you know what? I like it. It looks good. When have I ever been one to back down from a bright lipstick? Never. Except unless it is Iced Mocha from Revlon, which, as I said, looks like a shimmering butthole. So that's the end of it, guys. This is the finished look. I'm wearing Real Sexy lips. I have a very natural eye, Candid Coral blush, and the Dr. Jart BB cream on my face. This is a wonderful look. Thank you so much for watching this video, and have a good day, guys. Bye.